Hey everybody, and welcome to another episode of Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines with your host, jtcorpse. This is episode 8 of our Gangrel playthrough, and as you can see, we are now entering downtown, baby.
Let's drain it. Let's take it and leave it out for the sunrise.
We're going to have a lot of fun with this one. Think you could blow up our warehouse and get away with it? Ah, lick.
Let's pull out its eyes and its tongue and its teeth. I want its teeth.
Camarilla, fuck! Boys, I think we could all use a little entertainment. Those of you sitting in the first few rows will get wet. Son of a bitch!
Leave.
There's three of us, Rodriguez.
Yeah. Three of us.
What are you gonna do? Shoot us?
This ain't over. We'll find you. You too, Rodriguez. You're both dead. Nobody messes with a Sabbat and lives.
Keep moving. Trouble sure seems to like you. Good effort. Execution needs a little work.
All right, great. So this is where we first meet
like
Nines.
Shit.
Well, our second meet Nines. The first time was officially in the movie theater where
Should've
he technically
been more careful,
saved us.
Maybe. Bunch of shovelheads like that. They walk tough, but they scare easy. Just tear an ear off or something. You do that.
I remember
me?
That, yeah.
I got
so,
things to deal with.
Always reply to Nines.
Why don't you pay me a visit at the last
in
round
a calm...
tonight?
In kind manner,
you
unless you're
so
RPing.
Far, but it's time you heard the real story. This is a mean existence. Stay out of trouble, kid.
Okay, so as we move into downtown, we do want to head make a beeline straight for Nines and the last round. So here's what I do. I go and open up my character sheet and go ahead and pump up 2 points into Brawl. And then you're going to get a free point of Brawl. Once you talk to Nines, you have to go through several dialogue options to get to it, but you'll get a free point. And that'll be some XP saved. I was going in the wrong direction there, but then I was like, yeah, you know, I'll just cut back here. Instead of watching me run in the wrong direction, then try to run back. So I'm trying to make the cuts a little bit quicker here. And we're entering the last round now, and we're going to talk to Skelter here. And there's Jack in the corner. There's Jack in the corner! Sorry, a little horrible REM tribute there. And guys, if you're wondering why you're not hearing the in-game sounds right now, it's because, as I've explained probably a dozen or more times in the past, but just in case you're new here, it's because the copyrighted music that is in the game is not separate from the voice tracks and the narrations, so I have to include, like, pretty much royalty-free music in these areas where there's, like, loud music and club music playing in the background, so that's why we're not hearing anything. From Skelter talking, you won't be hearing Nines, at least in this environment, and Damsel as well. But a lot of the royalty-free tracks are really good, and I really wish we could separate it and put it in along and hear the narration as well, but unfortunately, or the dialogue, I should say. That's not possible. So here we go, and we pick up the Patty quest. And Patty is a ghoul that's in downtown in Club Confession, run by Venus, and she has a problem with some almost masquerade violations. She's becoming a nuisance, and the vampire, the kindred, do need to get rid of her. Here we are talking to Nines, and we're just going to go through some various dialogue options. I'm kind of skipping through some stuff real quick, and the main thing is trying to get to the point where I ask him to teach me how to fight better. But for right now, he's just talking shit on the Camarilla, which is, you know, fine. Great. The Camarilla needs to be talked shit on. I mean, gosh. So I ask him, aren't you part of the Camarilla? And he gets, oh, so what are you all about? I'm pretty sure I ask him, so aren't you part of the Camarilla or something like that? And he just gets angry. And I think Nines is a Bruja. Not a true Bruja. But he is a Bruja. I think all these guys are Bruja. I think Skelter and Nines and Damsel are all Bruja. And most Anarchs are. Most. There are some that aren't. Like Isaac in Hollywood. There he is. He's getting pissed. And then I'm like, you're sound like the Prince of the Anarchs. There's not really a good choice for either of those, so I just choose that one. And then this is any advice you can give me. Now he does that about the blood and how you can turn into a monster or whatever, but I'm really looking for that extra stat increase in Brawl. And as a unarmed, brawling character, I should have probably done 2 points into Brawl earlier on before coming into downtown. That probably would make some fights a little bit easier. Okay, sirrah, sirrah, baby. And there, can you teach me how to fight? And he's like, yeah, just put your fists up and don't put your thumbs inside your fist, because that's dumb. See, look how I'm doing it, says Nines. So guys, if you haven't yet, please be sure to hit subscribe or hit that like button. How about subscribe and hitting that like button at the same time? Huh? How about that? As we see, our brawl skill is now at 3 and we were at 2. Yeah, so just to let you know, I have been live streaming a Tremere run through here on YouTube. I think I'm going to come back to YouTube and just stream a little bit more here than I was on Twitch. So for anyone who's been following me and has to make the jump over to Twitch to watch my live streams, don't worry, I am going to be streaming here a lot more often and probably almost permanently, depending on how circumstances roll. That said, we are now talking to Damsel, and at first I was calling her Cammy for a long time because she addressed me as Cammy, and then that just got in my head, and I'm like, hey, her name's Cammy too. That sounds like a girl's name. And no. For the longest time, I was saying, this is Cammy. This is not Cammy. This is Damsel. She is a revolutionary Bruja who tells me about the influx of plague bearers within the city, the number of sick and dying people that are around. So I'm kind of being kind about, you know, the Anarchs. You know, the Anarchs helped me out before, so what can I do? And, you know, I want to get Damsel on my good side. Not that she really gives you anything special. She just gives you a little XP, but, you know, XP is always nice. And that's kind of what this run is about. That's pretty much what all my runs are about, are the XP. Barring my Salubri and Bali and Nosferatu and my previous Chimera. Okay, most of my runs were not about the XP. Most of my runs were just crazy, flapping in the wind. I don't know what the hell I'm doing. So I know a little bit of what I'm doing now, but, you know, I'm still not, you know, perfect in any way. So here we go, and we pick up the thaumaturgical creatures from the Tremere Chantry. And yeah, that's supposed to just tell you a little bit of history on gargoyles. Just that will come into play later on, much later on. And we'll go in here and we're going to talk to Maximilian Strauss, who is the Tremere Regent.
Greetings, Neonate. Might I assume?
I believe he's also the Primogen.
I have been
of the Tremere here in LA.
Sometime. Strauss. Maximilian Strauss. A regent is the leader of a chantry. I'm sorry, Neonate. The secrets of the Tremere clan are hidden from all but those who share our blood. Let me give you some advice, young one. As for what is going on here in Down, it seems that disease has been spreading at an alarming rate. Yes, indeed. My opinion is that the local Anarchs are responsible for these outbreaks. I see. Most disappointing, Neonate. You seem to show a startling lack of concern when choosing your associates in this new life. An interesting proposition. If you succeed in finding the cause of this epidemic and putting an end to it, I will compensate you appropriately for your efforts. Very well.
Okay, so we just got picked up this extra plague bearer quest from Maximilian Strauss there, and he's going to give us a great valuable item that's going to help us in our fight in a talisman. You will pick up numerous talismans on your way through this game, and he gives you one of them. After you complete the plague bearers, of course.
Help me! Help me! It's got them. It's coming for me now. It's coming for me.
Well, slow down. What's coming for you? Well, what's behind you?
Look, I'll level with you. We usually fake these things, you know.
Wait here. I'll go see if I can find them.
No, don't go down there. We've got to get out. It's coming. It's coming. It's coming.
Oh, you're just being silly now. Okay, so we are in the hospital. The haunted hospital. I put that in quotes. Haunted in the fact that there's not really a ghost here, but there is a being of incredible cruelty and evil. More so than a vampire, but as you're going through and going to her, remember to pick up that morphine bottle that's in the corner. There are several bottles of pills around here. All of it morphine. Morphine is very valuable. I think once your haggle's up enough, you can pick up... You can sell it for about $43 a pop if your haggle's around six. $43 sounds about right. And I believe vendors can only take a certain... There's an example where I was selling all my morphine to Fat Larry in downtown, and I think he only would take 10. So I had to sell my extra morphine, I think, to Trip at the pawn shop or at the Red Spot in Hollywood. But we're gonna just looking around here. I know where I'm going. It looks like I don't. I swear I do. But with all the updates that this game has, and Wesp and his team love to put little things here and there. Sometimes they may put something where something usually isn't, and I'm like, oh, this was never here before. And we're just gonna throw these pieces of wood. Well, usually, sometimes I get stuck on those pieces of wood a lot. The dynamics, the hit collision here in Bloodlines is a little wonky, a little janky. Another morphine bottle. I think that's all that's in this room. I think that's about all the pills that are in the hospital, just those two morphine bottles. If I'm not mistaken, I don't want to be talking out of turn here. I think I'm going to go around, what am I doing here? I don't know. I think I was remembering a shortcut, but the shortcut's not available yet. I swear you can avoid going, just kneeling under the ceiling, under the floor. This is the area. Just getting stuff out of the way. Like I said, you can get easily stuck on these because the hit collision in this game is really, really janky, so. Oh yeah, there's another bottle there, so don't forget that other bottle. So, three morphine bottles in the hospital. And this is where you can go underneath the flooring to go to progress forward, but I'm just gonna go and search this room real quick, and I don't think there's anything in here. There's another little place you can go into the floor here, and then we're just gonna jump over all this mess and not even have to worry about doing that. And this is where you would come up, go in here, go the wrong way, and we go this way, and we see some guy explode here. This is always fun. Chris Blush. And we will meet the beautiful, monstrous Pisha.
Real terror is not the sight of death. It is the fear of death. What is the fear of death? Terror of the unknown. Is it these eyes you peer into? No, I am not the unknown. You and I are closer kin than you and it were. Drinking blood. My birth name I tell no. My stay in this city is transitory. I seek relics of the occult traced here and would trade similar artifacts to acquire them.
And there is Pisha, ladies and gentlemen, just a monstrous creature that, similar to vampires, feeds off the living, but not in a way that you're really really used to. It's a little creepy. So, fact here is that, remember that cut-off arm you got from Gimbal? You remember that arm? You can take that arm and bring it down to Pisha and give it to her, and she'll give you $10 for that arm, and she'll eat it.
Hey there, Chief. Small world, huh? Yep, after that gallery, I didn't think I'd be able to get a job guarding a room full of jack squat from the boogity man. But then I get a call offering me this sweet night shift slot, and I'm back in the security game. Ah, well, enough about my lucky break. You, here to see one of the bigwigs, Chief? Would that be Sebastian LaCroix? Okay then, Mr. Yeah, you have a good power meeting, or...
Alright, after finally dealing with Officer Chunk there, we're gonna head up to the penthouse with Sebastian LaCroix. And, hopefully you haven't come to LaCroix first. Hopefully you went straight to the last round to talk to Nines Rodriguez, because I believe if you go to LaCroix first, Nines won't give you the option to boost your brawl stat, and that's if you're concerned about your brawl stat. If you're not concerned about your brawl stat, then by all means, come to LaCroix first.
There you are. I was informed of your presence in the building. Since you're...
Yes, that is. Of course I...
I had no doubt you'd prove my decision a prudent one. I trust you encountered no impediments to your progress on account of my person.
No, none at all.
That is the answer I like.
Replying with none at all preserves Mercurio as a potential arms dealer in the future if you absolutely require him. I saved him just because he's a good guy to have around. I guess say yes, sir.
Were you by chance in the military at all?
No.
I was an officer myself, actually. In Napoleon's ranks. There have been whispers.
Good for you, LaCroix. Yes, go on.
The police are investigating the Dane as we speak. Now, I'm not one to predicate a decision based on conjecture. So what I need is fact.
Okay, what do you need me to do?
You have three objectives.
Okay, three. One. Go. One.
I want you to examine the sarcophagus for anything. Do not, under any circumstances, open the Ankaran sarcophagus.
Is that one or two?
The last thing we want
So that was second.
Of our existence. So be careful what you do in front of them.
Got it, LaCroix. Yes.
Good. Oh. And it has come to my attention that you had an encounter with...
Some nonsense about anarchs. I didn't listen very carefully. I rarely listen at all. Boom.
If I may give you a piece of advice, always listen to others' words carefully.
No.
Now that that's out of the way.
All right, I still have something to do. I'll do it later. All right, I'm inviting questions first. I think I was just asking some questions here. Just maybe get some... I thought I could get some money
from
him. But nah, I didn't, so...
Good. I'm counting on an encore exposition of the talent you showed earlier. Go. And remember... Under no circumstances are you to open the Ankaran sarcophagus.
Okay.
We'll talk later.
Yeah, we'll talk later.
There's a boat waiting for you on the...
Okay. Hey, guys. Well, that's it for this episode of Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines, my Gangrel walkthrough. Thank you so much for joining me on another episode. Hey, and if you liked this episode, hit that thumbs up. It always helps me out. And if you enjoy my content, don't be scared to hit that subscribe button. Take care, guys. Bye.